Hello, my name's Simon Crafer. We're in Malaysia, not far from Kuala Lumpur, at Sepang International Circuit, and we're in the garage, the MotoGP garage of LCR, next to the machine of Alex Marquez. And this week's Tech Talk is about slipper clutches, and it's going to leak into engine brake electronics because they are connected. Can't miss that out. So let's start with the kind of the history, at least in my time until now. When I first got to Superbike World Championship, I was doing a couple of one-off rides in 93. The machine I was riding had no slipper clutch, and all of the bikes up until then had no slipper clutch in there. And so when I'd close the throttle, you know, and brake into a corner, and the rear end got light, the bike would start to chatter, you know, and bounce because the rear wheel is locking. You know, it doesn't have much weight on it because all pulling that front brake, all the weight's on the front. Not much weight on the rear wheel, and it's trying to lock and bounce, you know. So because of that, we would pull on the clutch to smooth that out. If it started hopping, you could pull on the clutch, disengage the clutch a little, let that rear wheel turn again, matching the wheel speed of the ground, you know. And then that chatter would go away. Same entering corners. I'll come to that in a moment. And so with the advent of slipper clutches, things made a good step forward, you know. You didn't have that chattering and bounce. And to explain what is a slipper clutch, I've got one, not from Alex Marquez's machine, the Honda, but I've got one from Moto2 that we're allowed to look at. And just to explain, so the clutch plates, the steels and these fibers, one by one, you know, one each, one of the other. They fit in there, steels and fibers, and they're the clutch plates, okay? So without the clutch plates, I'll show you what the story is. So that's the clutch from the outside. It's an FCC from Moto2. All of the Moto2 machines run the same. The invention was that when you've got the throttle on, it's like normal clutch. But when you close it and the torque goes the other way, twists the other way, the clutch, then the rear wheel causes, you know, some torque. The engine's trying to slow it down, the rear wheel's trying to speed it up, and it twists the clutch the other way. And look, I don't know if you can see it down the bottom there. If I twist it one way, it locks. Twist it the other way, and it opens. See that? See it opening up. And that's every time you close the throttle, it twists this way, opens the clutch, and the clutch slips automatically. So no longer do you have to slip the clutch yourself to stop that chatter. It does it by itself and smooths everything out. It was wonderful, you know, gave you one less job to do. Then we always had to play with the adjustment on it. And these ones use the clutch springs, the normal clutch springs that bolted together. The heavier those springs are, meaning the stronger, the more the clutch resists to open, you know, like I was showing before. So if you go light springs, as soon as you close the throttle, it'll open and freewheel. And if you put heavy springs in there, it's going to not want to open, give you more engine brake to the rear wheel. So in Moto2, for example, you've got a 80 newton meter, a 90, 100 and 110, and the riders can play with that, whatever they want, you know, to get what they want. But then when the slipper clutches came in, I still had to adjust myself, because rear tire from brand new at the beginning of the race or beginning of the session, towards the end, the grip changes, it drops down. So engine brake that was great for the lap time with a brand new tire, all of a sudden you go in, or at the end of the race especially, you go into the corner, lean over, close the gas, and the rear starts coming around because the grip's so low that the engine brake is making it let go, you know, and come around. So towards the end of the race, I had to open the throttle a little bit when entering fast turns to stop that rear wheel coming around. And then on the hard brakes, use the clutch a little bit to get it back into line because it had less grip. And that's where the electronics comes in now. Instead of having to do that manually, they started inventing electronics that open the butterflies, you know, for starters. Instead of the rider having to open it, the machine would open the butterflies, open the throttle a little bit to reduce the engine brake of the engine, okay? So basically opening the throttle for you. And problem was that with that is in the early days, say it was an inline four, all four of them, the difference between like point something of a millimeter open and closed was huge. So it was very difficult to get it right. Then they realized, rather than do all four, we'll just do one cylinder or two cylinders, you know? Different manufacturers do different things. But common is one now, because you can adjust that quite a bit to get the adjustment you want, you know? It's not such a difficult job. You can use it on one and less effect and more accurate. You can get the engine brake you want and or lack of. So now we had a electronically controlled amount of engine brake and the slipper clutch. And of course they go together, you know? Meaning if you have a lot of engine brake, we're gonna come to that. We'll do that first. Entering a corner, now you've got an engine brake you want, adjust, especially high RPM right in there. But if you've got a corner on the track that you're in a very low RPM because the gearing you've got works everywhere, you're happy with it, but that particular corner you go in and there is not enough engine brake. The rider's like, oh, I can't stop there. I have to try and use my foot brake, but it's on the right side. Can't get my foot there. And the bike's not turning, it's running wide. Need more engine brake. So they invented on the cylinders that aren't being used for the engine brake, the butterflies on the throttle, they use an exhaust valve on different cylinders, you know, so they can close and cause like a truck exhaust brake, you know, they can close causing back pressure and the engine makes more engine brake with that valve. So electronically they can give less engine brake by opening the throttle butterflies like I was describing before, and then they close all if the RPM drops low and you have less engine brake. They can make more engine brake with the exhaust, so everything working together, and the clutch obviously adjusted correctly, you know, to work with this. Doesn't open right when you need engine brake and close the exhaust. Imagine if the springs are too soft in here, it opens and you can't have engine brake because the limit is this. So you put heavier springs in and adjust with everything else. I know this is getting confusing, but so then the other thing too that I've noticed and I see, and more importantly here, I don't know how this works, but on the modern bikes, for MotoGP machines, I'm not sure how they do it, but I can hear when they go up through the box that the clutch slips at times on the drive. And it makes sense to me because they've got no cut now. You know, they're going from one gear to the other and it's a lot of torque. When you have the engine spinning at certain RPM and all of a sudden you have the next gear, even if it's seamless, you know, and goes into the next gear, that drop in RPM must cause a big torque to go through it, all the drivetrain, through the gearbox, through the chain, and very importantly, those things are going to be reliability problems, but very importantly, the final thing is the tire. And a big amount of torque hit will cause spin. And all of the manufacturers say, once you make the tire start to spin with this amount of power and torque, you can't get it to stop. So it's going to keep, so we don't want it to spin. And I can hear, I don't know how they do it, apparently, it's not electronic, but they can make the clutch slip a little as it changes gear and smooth everything out. I don't know about you, I love finding out about this stuff. Hope you enjoyed the tech talk, and we'll see you at the final round of the World Championship, Valencia, next race. Bye for now.